So this comes in from a younger collector. Not collector. I think he more is just into restoring stuff. And he's, I don't even know if he's 20 yet, but he's learning. And I fully support that. You got to start somewhere. And of course, these All-American 5 radios are where a lot of people start. And he said this is low volume. Now, we don't... Do we know who made this? Not that it's any... The schematic is anything special. Emerson Radio and Phonograph Corporation. Let's see here. Probably want to... There should be a cover that covers these screws, but you could put electrical tape over that. But let's see what we got here. One of these is generally for an external antenna. All right, let me do a little bit of a visual on this. It's just your typical All-American 5 miniature tubes. And hell with it. Let's just plug it in and see what it does. See what I hear. Just do it all in one cut here. Yeah, screwed up my plans. I was all set to roll, and now I'm... here doing videos, which is fine. I have a Trinitron that needs to be fixed. I have a Magnavox Astrosonic that needs to be fixed. And these are all... The Magnavox Astrosonic needs to find a new home ASAP. So hopefully someone will adopt that. Interesting that the volume control seems to make no difference in the minimal sound level. That's kind of a clue, actually. All right, so there is, it is tuning stations. There is no volume gain. There's no volume control. So let me inspect what's going on here. We'll do a little critique here real quick, just to kind of pass along some knowledge. So joints like this are not really acceptable. You always want to create a mechanical connection before you solder something. You don't want to just lay two things next to each other like this and solder them. You always want to create a J and a loop and create a mechanical connection. Kind of like this, but this is not really a good solder, and I know you're probably not finished with this, but I'm just going to go over this for the masses. This should have insulation on it. This has got B plus. If that was to short to ground, it would probably pop the audio output transformer. 150 ohm, that's our cathode bypass. It's a 470K, that's the grid bypass. It looks like we have a new orange drop here in place to the plate. That's a good thing. This looks okay. Like I said, the soldering, you need to create a good mechanical. This thing where you lay two wires next to each other and solder them, that's what you see on those really cheesy build a lamp controller with an IRF Z44 videos that are all over the internet, where they just take transistors and stuff and create this big spider web of parts with solder, the leads just touching and solder blobbed on them laying on the table, and it does some amazing thing, you know, a perpetual motion motor made out of a vacuum cleaner, that kind of thing. So that doesn't really work in real world. You want to create a good mechanical connection. I'm doing this with this powered up. This is great. Of course, your capacitors, you don't need to overrate the voltage. It's a waste of money, and it's really, the higher the voltage of the capacitor, the higher the ESR is for the given value. So these are probably supposed to be 160 volt caps. Stay with 160 volt caps. They're cheaper, and yeah, you don't need to go way over on the voltage. Just stick with 160. I don't care what the internet says. Go with what the manufacturer designed. And that's about it. That is about it. Oh, this here, this is a paper capacitor. This needs to be changed. And this is your, that's going from the plate to the cathode. So that's your capacitor that takes any RF off of the output. So yeah, that, red, black, orange, 203. Am I reading that right? Does that have an arrow on it? Yes, it does have an arrow. So 203. So there you go. 0.02. Soldering iron. This is a cold joint. You need a big soldering iron to do these chassis solders. I usually use 150, 200 watt iron if I'm going to do that. Other than that, we need to diagnose it, but just a little critique on the work. Need to create a mechanical connection. Need to get the paper out of here. Besides that, looking pretty good. You know, looking pretty good. Let's do some voltage measurements here. Let's maybe I'll get the analog meter just for entertainment value. Yeah, let me get an analog meter. Maybe this will be a little bit easier to see. So we're on the 250 volt scale here. So have to familiarize myself. So in the middle would be 125. Let's check here. And remember, we're going through a 70 watt light bulb, so I'm about 90 volts there, right? Let's go to this one. I'm a little bit less. That's okay. That's through the 1K resistor. So I am 75 volts right there. Let's come over here to the plate, which is the blue wire. I have the 90 volts there. That is good. Let's see what is on our cathode here, which is our 150 ohm resistor, which we have, let's see. Have a lack of convenience. Okay, so we have 4 volts on our cathode. Let's go back to the plate of the 12 AV6. Is that correct? That should have what, about 30 to 60 volts, and we have nothing, and I get a buzz from the speaker when I touch that. So there should be about a 470K resistor going from that to B plus, which we have this resistor right here with this wire soldered onto it. So we don't have any voltage there. So we're missing all the voltage on our detector tube. I'm going to grab the RCA book, because this is just a very generic radio. We can look at the schematic. So in the back of this, remember all these radios were licensed from RCA. So pretty much this poor book is coming apart. But you just go back here to the back, and there are schematics for everything that RCA licensed in this book. Super heterodyne receiver, automobile receiver, battery operated regenerative, FM tuner. This is prior to AC operated super heterodyne receiver. So this is basically it right here. So here we go. Here it is right here. AC-DC super heterodyne receiver. So here it is. This is this. So here's that 470. This is the 150. Here's the 470. Right? Here's your 150. Here's your 470. Okay. Then this here, C12, is this guy right here. And we should have voltage here, but we don't. We have nothing. We just have a hum. So that is our 8. And that should go to, this should be our 1K. Let's see, R11. Well, they got it as a 1200. That might be a capacitor. So where is our 470 here? They do show a capacitor there, C13, which is 330 picofarads. So where is our resistor here? Did we have a plate resistor delete? And is that correct? That would be pin 7, right? Oh, this is not going to give the pin numbers. So if we go back here and look at 6AV6, this book needs to be like rebound, because this book really has all of the information you could ever want for fixing these old radios. TUV, me learn alphabet. Okay, stand by, let me find this tube. Usually they put them in here in the 6-volt version, like 6AV6, which they do. And yes, pin 7 is the plate. So we have a missing resistor here. A 470, which should go to the secondary B plus supply. See, our B plus comes here. This right here, that C14, that is that paper capacitor that I said was what, a 0.02? See what they got here. Okay, where is C14? On this. Yeah, 0.02. Boy, this thing is right by the book. This radio is this circuit exactly out of the RCA receiving tube manual. So yeah, it goes through this 1K resistor, which is this guy right here, and then it should come over here with a 470. Okay, I'm seeing a 470 right here that's connected to this 3.3 meg, and that is this wire. This has our voltage on it. So this wire here is connected over to right here. So I have a feeling this is supposed to be connected over to there. But let me verify that. So that would be 765. Okay, pin 5 is diode 2. Well, diode 2. All right, no make sense of this now. So this is not exactly the same as this. This part of it right here is not exactly the same. They don't have this diode connected to the cathode on this one. So I'm thinking that he just soldered this resistor to the wrong place. I think this resistor is supposed to go over to here. None of this looks touched to me. So I mean, you can kind of tell what's been worked on and not. Now, I don't know about this. This is a 047 going from the diode to ground. All right, let's see what happens here. Just doing it with the radio powered up, safety first. Setting a bad example as always.
Incluya más personas.
Show the pride and gratitude of our nation. Our defenders, veterans, first responders, and the loved ones who sacrificed right alongside them, we can always do a little more. MegaDonation.org.
Every year, over 1 million fires burn in America. Fortunately, firefighters are on the job, saving life and property. And you can be a part of it. 7 out of 10 firefighters and emergency responders are volunteers.
Everything the average call.
What?
Financial advisor.
15. Another conked out car blocking the left lane, and if you're traveling through Woodland Hills, northbound side of the 101, I'm
fine.
Ooh, you could need a blambulance. Coming to pick up another BA5 midterms variant patient.
They're looking the trend, and they're the one NFL team that looked at their
their B-level quarterback and went, nah, we're good. The other way they go is they looked at their Christian Kirk salivating wide receiver and said,
we're still on the light bulb, so we're still a little bit reduced voltage here, but let's see what we got.
You're staying. We're going to figure this
we
out.
We have.
You're staying. And you're staying. And it hasn't
40 volts.
Yet, but Debo Samuel did show up to OTAs. That's so
guess I could measure that resistor before I solder it in. So 470K, it's measuring 511. That's well within the 300%. Tolerance these radios will deal with and not show any difference in performance. So we'll roll with that one. So first we'll take and straighten this out. All right. Take and straighten that out like that. Now this here looks like it's, is this pretty well secured here? That looks like he J-hooked it and wrapped it around the old lead, so that's good. So I'll take this and we'll straighten it out. Then we'll take our hookup wire here. We'll create a little loop in the end of the wire like that and bend it over. Then what we'll do, so stick that. Yes, I could just replace the resistor and be done with it, but this is edumacational. So stick that on there like that. We'll try and work it down a little bit and then we'll solder it. I kind of went overkill there, but then we'll take this and we'll cut it here. Right, I kind of went a little bit too long there. And we'll take this and bring it like this, easier with two hands, but I know have a cameraman, so bring this like this. See, now I've created a good mechanical connection here. Right, and it really doesn't matter if you connect it here or over here. We'll connect it right here just to double your pleasure, because I'll solder this whole freaking thing together, which will tie this to the tube pin to this, so it'll be one big blob. Right, so you end up with something like that. And we all have our own way of doing things. It's just I like to make it bulletproof so that as the solder ages it won't fail and break and pull apart. Now I might just take a minute and do something with this wire, and maybe I'll get rid of this capacitor. The book calls this to be a disc capacitor, the RCA book. We could take and cut that thing open. So what I'm going to do for now is I'm just going to clip this out. And I'm going to leave the leads kind of long. You can clip them right at the capacitor. You're not going to reuse the capacitor. So for now, what I'm going to do is, then what we can do is we can take, maybe take this sleeve and move it over here. So I clean that up. Don't hesitate to use disc capacitors in these radios. There's only one or two over here that are really critical, and the ones in the IF cans are critical. But disc capacitors for these radios are just fine. In fact, Zenith went to almost all disc capacitors in their later tube radios. That's why a lot of them still work that don't have silver mica disease. But yeah, I mean, clean that up. The mistake was here, and my only comment on this mistake is this type of mistake is easy to make. If you don't have a schematic, take out your phone, take a bunch of pictures from all angles, close-ups, from all different angles, in good lighting before you touch the first thing. That way you have record of it. You can just pull your phone out, dial in the picture, zoom in, and see what happened. I think we're good here. I'm debating whether I want to align the IF on this or not. Trying to discern whether this is a bad volume control or some other issue, and it might be some other issue. Because this thing seems pretty smooth.
Jacoby Brissett has played okay football. I can't say in those previous...
Now it seems to be working fine.
Respectfully, he's not going to have the same kind of team that he's having at his fingertips right now. And so I would expect him to be solid, of course.
And the stress she's brought in this family, we hate her for it.
Well, of green energy, which of course has just shipped a ton of manufacturing jobs and a ton of prosperity off to China. He sided with the Biden administration 100% of the time on policies that made our streets less safe, that defunded American police departments, and that made us all poor through the
40 volts there.
I'm not surprised that he's politically smart enough to know that he has to run from Joe Biden. I'm a little surprised at the shamelessness of it all, that the guy campaigned for Joe Biden, supported every single one of his policies, and pretends now on his TV commercials that he's never heard of him.
Which is really weird.
So 125 volts.
In Ohio, WHIO listeners know all about this.
90 volts.
And at the same time, he says Tim Ryan, who at first when he came in to Congress.
I think it should go a little louder.
That he had no interest in doing it. He's losing his on the floor all the time, condemning.
Where you can meet me on the dance floor or with the karaoke mic.
Yeah, there's LA Oldies. Yeah, that's wide open. Sick. See if we can help that out at all. These damn things are always off. Okay, I need to put it on the generator and align the IF. These things are always off. They're superior to these because they don't get silver mica disease, but they're always off. Should be one on the bottom. Is he gonna stick a metal screwdriver up in that thing's ass? Yes, he is. Pretty good.
Burgers are made with the highest quality ingredients, made fresh and by hand, made with a smile, and you.
It's use in
COVID again.
again. And next time, it could be worse. A lot worse. That's because every time someone gets COVID, they risk things like organ damage, breathing issues, even trouble remembering things. But if you're vaccinated, a booster helps keep you protected from
COVID. Yeah, sorry, lady. Not working, okay? Not working.
We can do this.
No, we can't.
Paid for by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services. Matthew.
That means everything in life.
Need to just tweak this real quick to see if I can pick up everybody's favorite station.
Kevin Durant leaves for the Warriors.
Now. I need to go the other way. There it is.
This is only a test. This is only a test. Today is a great day testing. This is only a test.
All right, is everybody happy?
This is a test. This is a test. This is only a test. This is only a test.
So these radios are not wide enough to get her. She's up above whatever these things tune to, 1550 or whatever. So you have to block her out.
Man, you want to do it the right way. You want to build it. We talk to make Doc Matter.
SM Priscilla, CBS News.
Well, people are famous on social media for a lot of reasons. They may be handsome or beautiful or funny, but Simba, the baby goat, is famous for his long ears. They are now 22 inches and apparently still growing. The goat has attracted thousands of followers on YouTube and other channels since he was born in Pakistan about 5 weeks ago. Christopher Cruz, CBS News.
Guess if I was a goat, I would have more followers.
Southern California's only 24-hour local news and traffic station. I'm Rob Archer. Top local stories at 9:05. Some new information about the crash in Orange that killed three people. And could a former district attorney replace George Gascon if he's recalled? That is a possibility. The tree.
Big difference in performance there, isn't there? We could barely hear it before I did the IF. Listen to it now.
Story material. For all these $5, you have the least.
In the name of so many, Maitreese Richardson, right? And we know that.
From the wear and tear and smoke coming from electrical lines. Which is probably part of our going on here. That's unfolding in Lake Elsinore. And our ongoing traffic jam around LAX Worldway Circle.
Police looking at the two armed holdups this weekend. It's not clear if the same person's involved in both, but it might be. First one happened Friday morning when a masked man walked into a Subway restaurant on Sepulveda, just south of Venice Boulevard, to order a sandwich and pull out a gun.
Boy, this thing is rock solid, man. These tube sockets are in great shape. This thing is rock solid.
The robber in both cases, very similar, but not exactly the same. Nurses who work at UC Medical Centers and student health facilities have now ratified a brand new 3-year contract with the university system. The
deal's called. So I'm going to try and upload this video today. Let's see how long it takes. This is Sunday, July 10th. It's 9:09 a.m. My time, Los Angeles.